He just had to talk about Muhammad. I know he was reading a script. I know that. But he just had to read what the script said about Muhammad. I don't say much about elections. All these politicians have to do is not say something stupid about Muhammad. I don't care if they talk about Muhammad. Just don't say something stupid, and they won't hear a word from me. Unfortunately, we've got a man who's running for president of the United States of America, quoting Muhammad without having the slightest clue what the quote actually means. But I know what it means, and you're about to know what it means. And once you understand what it means, you'll understand why a man who wants to be president of the United States should not be quoting these words. Joe Biden just said to his Muslim listeners,
"Hadith from the Prophet Muhammad instructs, whomever among you sees a wrong, let him change it with his hand. If he is not able, then with his tongue. If he is not able, then with his heart."
What a great quote. I wonder what Muhammad meant by it. Did Muhammad mean what Joe Biden apparently thinks he meant? Let's find out. In Sahih Muslim 177, a small dispute breaks out because a Muslim is about to deliver a sermon before the prayer. Another Muslim objects and points out that Muhammad would do the sermon after the prayer. So we have to do things the way Muhammad commanded. And then there's this quote. "I heard the Messenger of Allah say, whoever among you sees an evil action, let him change it with his hand by taking action. If he cannot, then with his tongue by speaking out. And if he cannot, then with his heart by hating it and feeling it is wrong. And that is the weakest of faith." So far, so good. But sometimes we have multiple hadiths, and one hadith will expand upon another hadith. Maybe we should check and see if Muhammad explains himself. The next hadith, Sahih Muslim 178, is basically a repeat of 177, but the one after that goes into a little more detail about what Muhammad means by the hand, the tongue, and the heart. Sahih Muslim 179. It was narrated from Abu Rafi, from Abdullah bin Masud, that the Messenger of Allah said, "There is no prophet whom Allah sent to any nation before me, but he had disciples and companions among his nation who followed his path and obeyed his commands. Then after them came generations who said what they did not do and did what they were not commanded to do. Whoever strives against them with his hand is a believer. Whoever strives against them with his tongue is a believer. Whoever strives against them with his heart is a believer. Beyond that, there is not even a mustard seed's worth of faith." So, prophets are sent to their nations, and they give commands. They establish laws. Their followers obey their commands. But later generations come along, and they don't obey the commands. So the true followers of the prophet have to strive against these rebellious people with the hand, i.e. by physically forcing them to obey God's law, or if they can't strive with the hand because their enemies are more powerful than they are, then they can strive with the tongue, i.e. by preaching and condemning and rebuking and winning support, or if it's too dangerous for them to verbally condemn the rebellious generation because they might get killed or something, then they can strive with the heart, i.e. by inwardly despising the evil and rebellion against the prophet, and by longing for the day when the prophet's commands can be enforced by the hand. According to Muhammad, if you strive with your hand, you're a believer, a Muslim. If you strive with your tongue, you're a believer, a Muslim. If you strive with your heart, you're a believer, a Muslim. But if you don't at least strive with your heart, if you don't at least hate the rebellion against the Prophet's laws, you have no real faith. You're not a Muslim. Now, when it comes to Muhammad, he's not simply a prophet sent to a particular nation. He's God's final prophet, and he's sent to the entire world. His commands are for everyone. There's a word for the collection of legal commands Muhammad brought, The word is Sharia. So Muhammad brought Sharia, and his followers obeyed his commands. But other people don't obey his commands. What are his followers supposed to do? They're supposed to strive against disobedience and rebellion with the hand or with the tongue, or at the very least, with the heart. Do you know what the Arabic word for strive here is? All the Arabic speakers who are watching right now certainly do. The Arabic word is jahadahum, i.e., wage jihad. Muhammad brought Sharia, and his followers have to establish and enforce it. They establish and enforce it through different forms of jihad. There's jihad of the hand, establishing and enforcing Sharia through fighting and carrying out the legal punishments, think ISIS. There's jihad of the tongue, preaching and condemning and calling for Sharia, think Anjum Chowdhury. And there's jihad of the heart, hating the evil around you and longing for the day when it will be destroyed. So, Joe Biden just told Muslims,
hadith from the Prophet Muhammad instructs, whomever among you sees a wrong, let him change it with his hand. If he is not able, then with his tongue. If he is not able, then with his heart.
Any Muslim who actually knows his sources and understands his religion just heard Joe Biden say, Muhammad commanded you to kill apostates and to kill homosexuals and to chop the hands off of thieves and to terrorize the unbelievers. So you need to obey him to whatever extent you're able, depending on your status in society. The United States of America is in rebellion against the teachings of the Prophet Muhammad, so wage whatever form of jihad you can against it, because if you don't, you're not a real Muslim. Probably not what he intended, but that's what informed Muslims just heard him say. Now, there are a couple of possibilities here. Joe Biden's speechwriter might be a total moron who did a Google search for great quotes from the Prophet Muhammad and put this quote into the speech without realizing what the quote is actually about. A more disturbing possibility is that an informed Muslim wrote that speech for Biden, and that it was a coded message to other informed Muslims. The message would be something like, this guy will say whatever we tell him to say. To prove it, we'll have him call for jihad against his own country. Vote for him, because he's ours now. For those of you who are cheering because I just criticized Joe Biden and raised a disturbing possibility about why he accidentally called for jihad against America, and for those of you who are freaking out because I just criticized Joe Biden and raised a disturbing possibility about why he accidentally called for jihad against America, let me say, this is not about Republican versus Democrat. George W. Bush said some of the dumbest things ever about Islam. This isn't about party. This is about stupid and dangerous. Whatever he was in the past, Joe Biden, right now, in 2020, is completely, utterly, totally stupid and very, very dangerous. More on this tomorrow.